so we're in the shed. I've got my little assistant here. And we're going to be trying to take the exhaust off, take the diff out, the whole rear end, and start to fix that up. So, Levi, what tools are you going to help with? What tools you got?
All of them.
All of them? Can you show us how you do some work? You use a fork?
Yeah.
What's the fork doing?
Yeah.
Yep. What does the hammer do? Good boy. All right, let's get to it. So I've got all the U-clips undone, connecting the exhaust together, but she's pretty rusted and pretty solid in that joint there. Also, that clip up there doesn't really want to come undone. Now, not putting this exhaust back on when it's all finished, it's pretty rusted, got a few holes in it, so when in doubt, cut it out. Squirting it.
Yeah.
So I took the drive shaft out. It's actually in pretty good nick, really. It needs to be cleaned up a lot. It's pretty rusty. Get in, get out, 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 get out, get in, 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 get out, the drive shaft's come up good. There's a bit of dust on it from going over it. All I used was a stripping disc on my angle grinder, as you can see like that. I advise, if you're ever gonna do it, get the brand Smith & Arrow. These, they've got polyurethane in them, I think it is. And they have lasted 1,000 times longer than these crappy Mitre 10 ones, which disintegrate in about 10 seconds. This is the only one I've ever actually put on here. That's done. They stripped the paint off all four doors of the car, the roof, the boot, a bunch of scrap metal, and also this drive shaft. So I'm gonna see how far that gets on the chassis too, but definitely recommend using these discs. All right, so the diff is out, finally. It's taken me the better part of the week. Just been taken easy, putting a fair bit of CRC and lubricants onto these bolts. It's been a huge pain in the ass. I didn't bother filming it because I wasn't getting anywhere fast at all. I had this big bar here that Bridie was using as a bit of leverage on some sockets to try and get these things undone without snapping them, but got there eventually. So all the bushings are rooted. What happens is over time, these old bolts with no oil, no maintenance, they rust on these inner sleeves. Makes it very, very hard for them to turn or want to come undone. So yeah, I didn't want to snap it off at the bolt head. That would have been pretty annoying to try and drill all that out. Anyway, it's out. Looks pretty gross and pretty crap, but once it's sanded back and with some fresh disc brakes on, get rid of the drums, new gasket, fresh oil, it'll be all right. There's no point in me showing you why wheeling it and sanding it. You know how it'll come up. I just secured the disc brakes off a WB Statesman, so I'll take all these drums off. Might change the diff gears out. So this is the tank. Took that out. Look at the amount of mud and shit that has been piling up in there. So put some new hoses on, but you know, sand it back, give it a paint. Quick shot of what's left of the rear end. Just gotta remove some of the fuel rails, brake lines, get up under there and sand it, take the cross members out. Gonna order some suspensions shortly, hopefully, because all this stuff's absolutely gone. Don't know if we're gonna go super lows or ultra lows at this moment, but definitely needs new bushings throughout for everything. It's hard to keep motivated just when you're sanding and doing rust repairs and whatnot, but we'll paint all that stuff up with KBS. It's a good product, and it's got myself a new little welder, so plenty to do. We'll leave it there for now and try and do some filming again the next few weeks.